Hi guys and welcome to my channel. My name is Dasha and I have recently graduated from Aalto University's master's program in real estate economics. And that is why today I would like to share with you how did I get into this program, tell you about the structure, how the studies are going and just give some tips and my opinion on the program. I would like to thank Aalto University for sponsoring this video. I couldn't be more proud of being Aalto University's graduate and continue my collaboration with them. So, in the autumn of 2016, I decided that I want to apply to Aalto University's program in real estate economics. And the application period usually takes place in December/January for master's studies and January for bachelor studies, so I had to prepare all of my documents before December. Even though the name of the program sounds like it would belong to the business school, it belongs to engineering school, so GMAT or GRE exams were not necessary in order to apply for real estate economics. So in that sense, the application was rather easy because everything I needed was my bachelor diploma, motivation letter, and such formalities as my CV and a copy of my passport. I did my bachelor's in Finland as well. I did it in English, and that is why I didn't need any additional English language certificate. However, if you come from abroad and not from an English-speaking country, you would need to pass TOEFL or IELTS. Regarding bachelor's diploma, of course, it had to match somehow the program I was applying for master's, and my bachelor's degree was in facility management, which was kind of a perfect match for real estate economics. So yeah, your previous degree should be closely related to real estate economics in this case, or land management, or something like this, but also you should have some basics of economics or statistics in your bachelor's studies. Regarding the academic performance, or well, your GPA, it should be either very good or excellent. My GPA from my bachelor's was 4.4 out of 5, so that's rather good, so I guess that helped me in my application. Another crucial part of the application is of course motivation letter, where you show the reasons why do you want to study this program, why this university, why in Finland, what you're gonna do with your career, how you're gonna use the knowledge you're going to get, and things like that. So back in 2016, when I was applying for this master's degree, the competition was 8 people for a study place. This year, competition was only 4 people per study place, so it really depends on the year. And you can find all the information regarding statistics and your chances at Aalto University's website. If you go to the webpage and in search put statistics, and the first page will show you that information. So master's degree in real estate economics at Aalto is structured as any other master's degree at Aalto. So you have to gain 120 ECTS points during your studies, meaning the program should take you approximately 2 years. For me, it took a bit longer. But that's another benefit of studying in Finland, that you build your own schedule. You're not necessarily in a hurry, well, unless you pay the tuition fee. So you can work and study at the same time, or study other topics in addition to your major as long as you like, and so on. So 60 credits, or well, ECTS points, are dedicated to your major, as I already mentioned, so studies in your own field. Then 30 ECTS you can spend for any other courses at Aalto. You can study anything you like, from marketing to rocket science, for example, or you can do a minor. So you can choose one topic, international business or construction, in which you will complete these 30 ECTS points. And finally, the rest of 30 ECTS you will spend on your master thesis. That's quite a lot. So yeah, you're gonna spend around half a year writing your master thesis. So during the major in real estate economics, you will learn various things. First of all, you will study the basics, how the markets work, You will get familiar with the Finnish real estate market. Then you will learn a few valuation methods. For example, first what we learned was discounted cash flow, valuation of an investment. Then in one course we were learning how to calculate value of real estate based on the recent transactions. We used different statistical methods. Then you have courses dedicated to land management and law and rules that are related to land tenure and management. Then there are several law courses you gotta go through. And finally, you will study property and facility management, where you're gonna study all these kind of modern techniques of workplace management or managing buildings in general. So yeah, these kind of things. I must say that the majority of the courses in the major were rather hard. I spent a lot of time working on my homework, on our team projects, especially when those projects involved calculations and evaluating some buildings or working on some case studies, analyzing some investments. Those were pretty hard, and what I would really recommend to you is to maybe before you start your studies in real estate economics pre-study, I recommend two courses on LinkedIn on real estate analysis and commercial real estate analysis. I will leave the links to you below in the description box to this video. But otherwise, what has been really great during my studies is the study group. We always helped each other. We gathered together either in library or at somebody's place to study together, to fight through this together. And that was pretty good time. You know, I remember those moments now with the warmth in my heart. So yeah, tip number one, I would really recommend you to go through your major courses during the first year of studies. That would be easier for you, it will be more comfortable for you, less stress, and well, more results. Why do I recommend to take the major courses during the first year? Because, well, yeah, you have a possibility, if you feel like it's too much of work for you at that very moment, you can postpone some of the courses for the second year. However, you will still need to do your electives and stuff, so I would rather focus on doing the major studies in the first year and second year focusing on your electives and master thesis. Second tip, do not hesitate to ask teachers and professors for more guidance or for more reading materials if you feel like you're falling a bit behind, or if you feel like you would like to go further and you want to learn more than curriculum offers. They will be always happy to help. They will be always help not only with studies like as they are, but also recommend where to look for internship, for instance, or what electives to take and so on. Third tip, join organization called Fundi. Fundi is this kind of student organization that is made for networking. All alumni and professionals in the field usually gather for some events during the year, or some companies come with offers to Fundi to organize tours to their companies. So you can visit various firms in the Helsinki area during your studies to familiarize yourself with the potential workplaces and make important connections. So that's really cool. Plus, in this way, you will be more involved in student life, and it will be easier for you to find new friends. Another great thing about studying in real estate economics program is that many courses are done as case studies or case projects. Well, you do some kind of team work, you write a report or investment memorandum in a team, and you do it for a case company. So some company from the field comes with a problem, and you in teams look for some solutions, or yeah, try to evaluate some potential investments. So that's really interesting, and you should definitely also take advantage of those case studies when you visit other companies Also, you can try to make connections and see where would you like to work after graduation. If you're an international student coming to study real estate economics, I must warn you, almost all students in your group will be Finns. They are coming from the bachelor program at Aalto University that lets them in without a separate exam. Or, well, other Finns that graduated from bachelors in other universities will also apply to that program. But you shouldn't be kind of scared of that. Everybody is super friendly. I was really surprised how they took me in, me and other guys who came in only in the master's phase to Aalto University. Everyone is really eager to learn more about you, where you come from, and so on. So be open, plus there will be some international exchange students coming to the program, so you're not going to be alone. University has great support for international students, so if any problem appears, there will be people to help you. You will have a personal tutor, which you can contact regarding anything like in normal life, how to go to shop, where to get some stuff. They will help you with everything. Now I want to share a few things that you should consider before applying. So first of all, the program is really Finnish market specific. So in case you want to go to work abroad after your graduation, you should study on your own. You should study the market of the country where you want to work. Even though the program focuses on Finnish market, of course, all the financial things you're going to learn, they're universal, so they can be used anywhere in the world. But keep that in mind. Second thing, which I think some of my fellow students kind of didn't know, so the program focuses exclusively on commercial real estate and doesn't go through any residential investment scenarios and so on. So if you want to work in residential area, again, you would need to study a bit more on your own, but I guess that's not a big deal because, well, in all the market reports you're gonna read, there will be always a residential part covered as well. And finally, I think very important tip to keep in mind that you have only 2 years of studies. So basically you have only one summer when you can do your internship. So pick wisely, because that's probably gonna be the place to do your master thesis. I want to make a separate video about writing master thesis and graduating and about career opportunities after studying at Aalto. But yeah, basically you have one summer when you can try in what company you want to work or in which area do you want to go to property management or managing investments or do you want to be more in construction and so on. So yeah, first of all, you will probably write your master thesis for that company, and that will be your kind of easiest way then to kicking off your career. As I said, learn about companies in Finnish market, network, and do internship, and in that way, when you graduate, you will have everything in order to start your great career in real estate. I think that's it for me for today. Thank you for watching. I'm sorry for maybe my behavior. It's been a while that I've filmed a video, but hopefully I can now make videos at least once a week to educate you on education in Finland. If you have some questions about studying at Aalto or specifically about Real Estate Economics Master's program, please leave them in the comments to this video. I will be happy to answer. Please also let me know if you have some topics in your mind you want me to film video about. As I said, I want to film about master thesis and graduating, maybe about looking for jobs in Finland and so on. Just let me know. I will also leave all kinds of links to Aalto University admissions process and my programs pages for you to study more specifically. And I will leave you a few blog posts that I wrote to all those blog pages. So yeah, again, feel free to ask. I wish you a great day, a great week, and hopefully see you soon. Bye.